You see, no one else can sell it, cause they're too afraid to tell it, but I'll tell it if I may be so bold. It starts here in the city, on a street that's kinda pretty, in an old but very charming brownstone. See, it was four stories high, and every story makes you cry for all the former residents who were gone, 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 gone. The lion in the visiting roar, because she had to put them out of their misery. A little bit odd, but his wife put all his odds to shame. See, he was really full of shit, and with his wife he had to split, because her crazy made his crazy look tame. Now when he made her his wife, he made a promise for life, but then he's straight and one can understand why. But on a dark Friday morning, without any Friday warning, he woke in and the prince said goodbye. So for all his calls, then he would die, because she had to put him out of his misery. Because the misery's all he'd shown. And sure, he's now dead, but hey, on that bed, he will never ever leave her alone. She ought to put him out of his misery. Because the misery's all he'd shown. And sure, he's now dead, but where the angels be to trail, he will never ever leave that odd Mrs. Dime alone. She bore her witness to her neighbors and her business too. She couldn't let them live anymore. So with a murderous rage, she set a murderous stage, and her eye came to be in her favor. When with a big butcher knife, she went and cut away the life to judge the souls of her unfortunate neighbors. Of all her poor, unfortunate neighbors, because she had a poor enough.